Thank you. Thank you. Should I set the world rolling? Okay, my question to you is very clear. What influence will season have on your results? You have done it at the intervals, 8 locations, 3 sets of samples. So the samples were taken at a relatively close time interval. So overall, what influence will season have on your results?
Thank you. Yeah.
Ikamat is the second Ikamat soon, third is not soon. Now one dose is to be added. Now the question is, what can we do about it?
Sir, this is the problem of the people. They are functioning in front of them. Now, they are the gates that should have been suffering. We talk about pollution and engineering from the other side. Now, even in Sri Lanka, we have this more of a study to find out what you want to do. distributes with the main. That is the main source of pollution. The previous studies also have concluded this. There are studies that have done in India using remote sensing to actually locate these giant pollution clouds and their behavior. But in Sri Lanka, we have not done such a remote sensing. So that is why I propose that this remote sensing via temperature measurements could be done as in the future. I hope that answered your questions.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning all of you. My research topic is optimum location suitability analysis for tsunami warning centers. This slide shows the outline of the presentation. As we know, tsunami was the worst natural disaster ever happened in Sri Lanka, killing more than 31,000 people and left 900,000 people homeless, including 6 December 2004. This disaster occurred as a result of earthquake happening. Problem statement. In the year of 2004, there was no inmate war even in the short period of time. After this disaster, there are 77 early warning towers established in the coastal area of Sri Lanka in the year of 2005 and 2006. It is nearly more than 14 years by now. So, within these years, there were many geographical and social changes as well as many other factors have been changed. It is really important to check the location, coverage, and the effectiveness of these tsunami towers are adequate or not to the many people. The aim of the research is shown in the slide. There are four main objectives in this research: to find out whether the strength and the coverage of the existing towers are adequate or not. Next one, to identify what are the factors which are effective for the location of tsunami early warning towers. Third one, according to the parameters finding out, verify what are the best locations for the warning towers. The last objective, to compare the existing location of the tsunami towers with the new identical locations. This slide shows the methodology of the research. This slide shows the data collection methods. These are the softwares they use to analyze the data. This study area, it is impractical to find out the best locations of early warning towers for the whole country. I don't know that it's only for coastal areas in this region. This area belongs to southern province, which has 4.6 kilometers. The area was selected for 2 kilometers inside the country of the coastal belt. In Madhya district, more than thousands of people died during this disaster, and there was a vast change in the effect of tsunami happening in southern coast. From the southern early warning towers in Madhya district, 4 towers belong to my study area in the locations of all 4 towers are in the working condition. It was needed to find out the actual location of these 4 towers. For this, CT-Droid and RGS software has been used. Range of the existing towers. According to the data which was collected from the Disaster Management Center and the Wind Region, the coverage of 1 towers in 50 locations were selected and interviewed the community regarding the early morning siren. In this slide, it shows the locations which early morning siren could be a moment. Three buffer zones were developed to determine the actual coverage of the tsunami early morning towers in GTA. It identified many locations and the 1.5 km buffer zone was not covered by early morning siren at the daytime. So, the coverage of the early morning towers was taken as 1 km away from the base of the tower. In the research area, there were 43 ground level images who were affected by tsunami disaster happened in 2004. This slide shows what are the areas covered by the next. intervention divisions as shown in the slide just covered in the tsunami tower power for situation. Thousands of people who are living in these areas have a high risk for a future from disaster. Conclusion. The coverage of the existing tsunami is not adequate. Both geographical and social factors should be considered when finding the optimal location of the tsunami towers. Several tsunami towers are required to cover the coastal area in between moderate and weather. 13 ground radar indications in the research area are not covered with the tsunami towers as well as any other areas that should be covered. Record causes of the research. Any mutation of the green tsunami is covered in the areas which do not have any protection. Make a system to inform the community using the mobile warning system. Practice the communities with the tsunami evacuation rules. Appointing persons such as ground radaring in the most risk areas to keep updated by early warning messages in respective authorities. Thank you very much. Have a good day.
Thank you, Lieutenant Mamiarachi, for that presentation. It's open to questions now. Let me just ask a question to begin with. Now, you are talking about vulnerable locations for a future tsunami. Now, obviously, there is a coastal engineering dimension involved in this research. How did you incorporate that part into your research? Did you hear my question, please? Lieutenant Manyarachi, did you hear my question? Yes. But should I repeat it again? Your research would naturally incorporate or include something on a coastal engineering dimension with respect to tsunamis and when you identify vulnerable locations. How did you go about doing that? It wasn't very clear to me. Could you kindly repeat your answer again? If not, are there any other questions? Any other questions? I would like to ask you another question. So, it wasn't very clear to me how many further locations you would have identified as vulnerable areas. Typically, could you kindly tell me how many locations and what sort of a cost would that involve and who will do it?
Existing early warning towers located in my research area. Actually, but in this research, definitely it need another three towers to cover these areas, except the police or any other river boundaries which are covered for this work. Other thing is, for a one tsunami tower, it will go around 15 minutes.
Any other questions, please? Could you please tell us the present tsunami towers, who maintains them? Who maintains the present tsunami towers?
The Sri Lankan government, sir, with the aid of Disaster Management Center, they are the responsible for the working condition and the present condition of these tsunami towers. Disaster Management Center. They are the responsible persons for this reason.
Have you presented your research to the Disaster Management Center?
Sir, the Praveen Kodipilli, Mr. Praveen Kodipilli was the, at that time, assistant director of the early warning committee in Sri Lanka, sir. I talked with him and we discussed about this figure, sir. They also having this problem actually, sir, how the one tower is actually about, sir, 15 million of cost. Actually, if we have coverage all over Sri Lanka with tsunami towers, actually the number will be very high. So they are, as my recommendations, I show some recommendations rather than sometimes say locating tsunami towers, the mobile warning systems. They are improving those things and now they are practicing those calculation drills to face this situation in future, sir.
Right, thank you. Any others? Any questions from any other previous authors?
Previous authors?
Sorry, sir, I didn't get the questions.
No question, yes. I was just wondering if there are any final questions.
Very sorry, sir. I didn't get your questions.
No worries. Good luck with your future research. Okay. So with that, we have gone through all the presentations for the morning. So I would like to just sum up at this time all the things that we have done. Yes. So we have been through 4 research papers this morning. They were very good, very interesting. And so the first paper was essentially on the problem of residential building and its effect on water bodies. So and the wastewater volume that is being generated, this is a highly relevant topic today. And in the context of growing populations in urban areas, and the paper dealt with some important issues related to the grey water print. final paper on the tsunami warning towers once again. I guess it's an important issue. There is a word, the vigilance part. I mean, just because it happened 16 years ago, we cannot just sit back and relax. We need to be prepared at any time for a thing like this. So the optimum locations of tsunami towers is an important thing, and the issue of vigilance, and for the Disaster Management Center and the Disaster Management Ministry, this research is an important thing. So I would like to thank all the researchers and the presenters and those who asked questions and added to this discussion. I would want to say a final thank you to you, and with that I will end. Thank you for your presence, thank you for the questions, and the presenters once again.
Head of the Department, Department of Civil Engineering, Dr. Ramya Kumar Nayakar, to present the token of appreciation to the chairperson, Professor S.S. Premkumar Surya. To assist her, I cordially invite Senior Lecturer, Department of Civil Engineering, Dr. Ishan Dias.